to the tunnel for the free. I rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around and didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. For the stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came a whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. The notches on his pistol numbered 1 and 19 more.
1 and 19 more.
Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. He was an Arizona Ranger. Texas Red,
after Texas Red.
Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
The morning passed quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Both were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death.
About to meet his death.
Stopped to make their play, and the swiftness of the ranger is still talk about today. Texas Red and not clean leather for a bullet fairly ripped, and the ranger's aim was deadly with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.
It was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. There before lay then the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match a ranger with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron.
When he tried to match a ranger with a big iron on his hip.
Big iron on his hip.